हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माइसेल्फ डॉक्टर कीर्ति श्रीराम कुलकर्णी एंड आई एम फ्रॉम गोखले एजुकेशन सोसाइटीज आर्ट्स कॉमर्स एंड साइंस कॉलेज जवार। फ्रेंड्स, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई वुड लाइक टू वेलकम यू ऑल इन द SYBSC क्लास। आई विल बी टेकिंग योर पेपर 3, दैट इज एनालिटिकल केमिस्ट्री। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल सी व्हाट इज द सिलेबस ऑफ सेमिस्टर 3, पेपर 3, एनालिटिकल केमिस्ट्री। द सिलेबस इज असाइन बाय द यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ द मुंबई एंड यू हैव टू लर्न ओवरऑल 3 यूनिट्स इन दिस सेमिस्टर। सो वेरी फर्स्ट यूनिट इज इंट्रोडक्शन टू द एनालिटिकल केमिस्ट्री एंड स्टैटिस्टिकल ट्रीटमेंट टू एनालिटिकल डेटा। So in this chapter, you have to learn about role of analytical chemistry. So in this, you will learn the language of analytical chemistry, important terms and their significance. Then you have to learn what is the purpose of chemical analysis, which is based on analysis size of sample and their type. Then you have to learn classical and non-classical method of analysis, their types and importance. In the next part of this chapter, you have to learn the significance of sampling in analytical chemistry. What are the different terms, what are the different types of sampling and the sampling techniques. In the third part, you have to learn result of analysis. So here you will learn what is error and what are their types. Then precision and accuracy. Then correction and determinate error, and you have to solve some numerical problems regarding this topic. Then in the second unit, it will be classical method of analysis. Here you have to learn the titrimetric method. What are the different terms involved in titrimetric analysis? Then what is volumetry and titrimetry? The conditions suitable for titrimetry, their types, that is neutralization, redox, precipitation and complexometric titrations. Then you have to learn what are different tools that are used in titrimetric analysis. Then you have to learn standard solution, that is primary and secondary solutions. Then you have to learn detail about neutralization titration. What is the concept of pH, its importance, how to find out end point and equivalence point. Then determination of endpoint using indicators, potential change and conductance. Then you have to learn how to construct titration curve of strong acid, weak base and strong base and weak acid. Then in the last part of this chapter, you have to learn gravimetric analysis. General introduction, its types, then precipitation gravimetry, various steps involved in gravimetry, what is role of digestion, filtration, washing, drying, ignition, etc. And in the last part, you have to learn application of gravimetry. Then there will be unit 3, which is instrumental methods 1. Here you have to learn about the basic concept of instrumental methods. Relations between analyte, stimulus and change in property. Block diagram of any analytical instrument. Various types of analytical instrument based upon optical interaction, electrochemical interaction and thermal interaction. Very important part of this topic is spectrometric interaction of electromagnetic radiation with matter, that will be absorption and emission spectroscopy. Then statement of Beer-Lambert law, its combined mathematical expression, validity of the law, derivation of the law and some numerical problems. Then you have to learn about instrumentation for absorption spectroscopy. Here you will learn instruments like colorimeters and spectrophotometers. Then detailed components like source, sample holders, filters, monochromator and detector of these instruments. Lastly, you have to learn application of UV visible spectroscopy, that is qualitative and quantitative analysis. And finally, you have to learn about photometric titration, its principle, instrumentation, type of photometric titration curves, and numerical problems. So friends, your overall paper will be of 100 marks, that is of theory paper, and you have to appear for 50 marks practical. So overall weightage of this part is 150 marks. So now we will start with our unit 1, that is Introduction to Analytical Chemistry and Statistical Treatment of Analytical Data, that is part 1. Why there is part 1? Because same chapters you have to learn in the second semester also. So friends, up till now in the last year, you have learned about physical chemistry, organic chemistry and inorganic chemistry. So why this year there is different topic called as analytical chemistry? What is its importance? That we will see in this chapter. So as we all know, everything is made up of atoms and molecules. That means the study of matter that you learn in physical chemistry. In case of organic chemistry, you have to learn everything about carbon. So carbon compounds are so vast in the nature, you have to learn a whole paper about this, that is organic chemistry. And in inorganic chemistry, you have to learn about metals and non-metals, that is overall periodic table, its properties, their applications, everything about metals and non-metals. But when it comes to its actual application, the part of analytical chemistry come in front of us. So analytical chemistry basically deals with what is present in the matter and how much present in that matter. So therefore, what is the importance of analytical chemistry? It is the science obtaining, processing and communicating information about the composition and structure of matter. So when it comes about the question that what is present in given sample and how much present in given sample, you have to study analytical chemistry. So basically, it is science of determining what is present and how much present in the matter. So now, what is role of analytical chemistry? Basically, it deals with identification, characterization and estimation of the components in a sample. So while I am saying all these words, you will have so many doubts in your mind, right? So first of all, you will ask me, what is a sample? So sample is nothing but a small part of universe. Now you will ask me, what is universe? So suppose you have a large well in your sidearm, or there is bucket full of water, and out of that you are taking only one mug or one glass of water. So that one glass of water is called as sample. And the bucket or the pond or well is called as universe. So universe has very large size, right? And therefore, it is not possible us to find out what is present in overall universe as it has very large size. So what you have to do, you have to take a small part out of that, which is called as sample. Are you getting my point? So now you will come to know why analysis is very important, because whatever part of sample you will take, that will represent your universe. So when you have to learn universe, you have to select the sample very carefully. Now what you will do? You will take your sample and you will give different type of analytical treatment to it. Why you will give that treatment? So, to find out what is present in that matter and in how much quantity, because it will have many different components. So, component means various part of that particular sample. So, what is role of analytical chemistry? Basically, it will identify. Identify means what is present in that matter. Then, characterization. Characterization means in how much quantity, what are the different components, what are their basic characters. That also analytical chemistry will find out. And finally, estimation. Estimation means how much amount is present. So, it is very simple that in a given matter, how much is present and what is present is determined with the help of analytical chemistry. So, we will see that in analytical chemistry, it is very important to find out what is actually present in the matter. That is called as qualitative analysis. See, quality means quality of any particular matter. That is called as what is present. So, it is called as qualitative analysis. And in second question, in how much quantity that particular component is present, that is called as quantitative analysis. So, now you will have question in your mind that why we have to find out all these things. So, it's very simple that in air, how much pollution is present, how much different type of metal particles or pollutants are present, that we can find out using analytical chemistry. Similarly, you can find out the salt content in sea water, then how much amount of pesticide is present in vegetable. This type of different questions are solved using analytical chemistry. Very simple. Up to 11th and 12th, you have learned titration, right? So, in titration, you are finding out how much amount of particular component is present in your given solution. So, it is nothing but application of analytical chemistry. So, you will see now what is the significance of analytical chemistry. So, it is a science of chemical characterization and it is concerned with the methods used in chemical analysis. So, now you will ask me what is chemical analysis, right? So, chemical analysis is nothing but it is the identification and measurement of chemical components of a sample of particular substance. Means, in analytical chemistry, you will use various techniques called as chemical analysis. And by the help of that, you will find out quality of the substance as well as quantity of that components in the substance. So, in simple language, whatever knowledge you have gained in physical chemistry, organic chemistry and inorganic chemistry, you will utilize your knowledge in analytical chemistry to find out what is present and how much is present. So, being analytical chemist, you should possess an extensive knowledge and understanding of fundamental principles having various methods of chemical and instrumental analysis. So, he will use various principles and techniques that he learns in various other parts of chemistry and he will apply it in analytical chemistry. In this overall process, you can modify your instruments, you can modify your knowledge and then you will come to the conclusion of qualitative and quantitative analysis. So, very first topic which is important in this part is what is the objective of analytical chemistry. So, very first objective is fundamental knowledge about principle and techniques used in qualitative and quantitative analysis. So, what is the meaning of that? Whenever you apply your knowledge, it should be very fundamental. In simple language, I will explain you. Suppose you want to sieve your tea. What you will do? You will use a sieve and then you will just pour your tea in that. What will happen? Your tea will come in your cup and the remaining part of the tea leaves will come in your sieve. So this is the basic separation that we are using from our childhood. So it is just simple principle of separation, and same type of different techniques are used in our analytical chemistry. So simple type of principles and techniques are applied over here. The second objective is research in various aspects of subjects. See, only knowledge is not important. The knowledge should be applied for the development of human being as well as the other species. So what you have to do? You have to do research for upgradation of our life, and that is applicable in analytical chemistry. The third objective is identification of substance and its structural elucidation. So as we all know, a science person has always interest in no matter what is present, how much present, so he will always break that particular matter and try to find out, identify its particular component and also its structure. So same part is applicable in analytical chemistry. The fourth objective is high degree of sophistication and determination of impurity at very low level. So see, it is very important part, as whenever you apply any method, it should be applied very sophisticatedly. Similarly, whatever sample you are using, you should not destroy its fundamental properties while doing experiments. So whenever you apply any method, it should be very sophisticated without changing the property of that particular compound. And next is determination of impurity. See, every compound has various impurities which should be resolved or which should be removed. So analytical chemistry will find out lowest level impurities in particular matter. The next objective is development of new methods of analysis. So we all know that old methods always become older and older, and there are always challenges in front of us. So always you have to develop various techniques and new methods for analysis. The next one is to minimize production and analysis cost. This is also again very important, because whatever experiment we do or whatever production cost is there for various substance in this world, it should have minimum production as well as analysis cost. We should not waste our money, our time and our energy while doing these experiments as well as production. So, as an analyst, it is very important to minimize the production and analysis cost. And the last one is very important, that is development of methods which are environmentally friendly. See, whenever you develop any method, it is very important that it should be environment friendly. We should not harm our environment while doing various experiments. So the last point is very important. So now we will come to the main part of this chapter. So whenever you do experiment, what you have to get? You get one experimental value, right? So suppose you are doing titration, suppose you are doing gravimetry, that I think you have done in 11th standard. So when you do or you perform any experiment, you get a particular value of that experiment results. So that is called as experimental value. And one value is expected one, right? The result which is given by your teacher, let's say for the example, which is called as expected value. So these two values are very important for our results. Result means result of our experiment. So regarding these two terms, that is your experimental value and your expected value, there are different definitions. So very first definition is called as error. What is error? It is the difference between the observed value and the expected value. That is called as true value, right? So error is nothing but the difference between observed value, that is the value you got, minus ट्रू वैल्यू मीन्स द रिक्वायर्ड और एक्सपेक्टेड वैल्यू, राइट? आर यू गेटिंग दिस? इट्स वेरी सिंपल. इट इज नथिंग बट डिफरेंस बिटवीन वॉट यू गॉट एंड वॉट इज एक्सपेक्टेड, राइट? सो द नेक्स्ट टर्म इज एक्यूरेसी. यू माइट हैव यूज दिस टर्म मेनी टाइम्स, वेरियस थिंग्स. ओके, वॉट इज दैट एक्यूरेसी? इट इज द एग्रीमेंट बिटवीन नंबर ऑफ ऑब्जर्वेशन एंड द ट्रू वैल्यू, राइट? वॉट इज एग्रीमेंट मीन्स वॉट इज द नियरनेस ऑफ ट्रू वैल्यू एंड ऑब्जर्व वैल्यू. सो इन सिंपल लैंग्वेज वी विल से हाउ मच एक्यूरेट इज योअर आंसर. सो हाउ यू विल फाइंड आउट दैट? वॉट एवर आंसर यू गॉट, दैट इज योअर ऑब्जर्व वैल्यू, एंड वॉट एवर आंसर इज एक्सपेक्टेड. सो इफ द टू वैल्यूज आर वेरी नियर टू ईच अदर, यूअर आंसर इज एक्यूरेट, राइट? एंड सपोज द योअर वैल्यू इज फार अवे फ्रॉम द एक्सपेक्टेड वैल्यू, देन यूअर एक्यूरेसी इज लेस, राइट? So accuracy is nearness of true value and observed value. Next term is called as precision. What is precision? It is the agreement between the number of observations in the given set of observation. When suppose for a particular experiment, you take suppose 30 to 50 samples. So you will get 30 to 50 values, right? Suppose all values are near to each other, then you will say that precision of your data or precision of your result is very good. And suppose whatever 30 value you get, all are different. So then you will say that precision is not good, right? So precision means agreement between number of observation in given set of observation. The last one is reproducibility. What is reproducibility? That whatever experiment you carry out, it should express the precision between laboratories, collaborative studies applied to standardize the methodology. Means whenever you perform any experiment, you get some data, it should be universal. It should be reproducible wherever you go. If you go in any other laboratory, any other collaborative study, any other part of world, the same method should give you similar results, or your data should be reproducible. It should not happen that one part of the world the data is coming different and other part it is coming different. So whatever you perform, it should have similar values. That is called as reproducibility. So further part of this chapter we will see in our next lecture. Thank you so much, my dear students.